Hello friends, I am Parul Divakar, Assistant Professor. Today, we are going to deal with an interesting episode of B Pharma on an important title, Accountancy. Our subject specialist is CA Anurag Jain and myself. Accountancy is divided in two segments, Accountancy 1 and Accountancy 2. Today, we are dealing with the first segment, that is Accountancy 1. So, let us start our episode while looking at what we are going to learn today. This topic consists of 5 modules. Module 1, Introduction and Principle. Module 2, Ledger and Ledger Posting. Module 3, Journal Entry. Module 4, Trial Balance. And Module 5, Cash Book and Bank Reconciliation Statement. So, let us start with the very first module, Module 1, Introduction. Accounting appears to be a purely practical subject that would be a very easy to focus just application of techniques and procedures. However, accounting is more than just a set of calculations, unless we understand and interpret the figure we produce. The calculations are pointless. Accounting provides information for a wide variety of different users and purposes, and its practices can only be properly understood and assessed in relation to the economic and social environment in which they are applied. Principle of Account. Definition of Accounting. American Institute of Certified Public Accountants, that is AICPA, which defines accounting as the art of recording, classifying, and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money, transactions, and events, which are in part at least of a financial character and interpreting the results thereof. Accounting is the analysis and interpretation of bookkeeping records. It includes not only the maintenance of accounting records, but also the preparation of financial and economic information, which involves the measurement of transactions and other events relating to entry. Objectives of accounting may differ from business to business, depending upon their specific requirement. However, the following are the general objectives of accounting. First, to keeping systematic record. Second, to ascertain the result of the operation. Third, to ascertain the financial position of the business. Fourth, to portray the liquidity position. Fifth, to protect business properties. Sixth, to facilitate rational decision making, and the last, to satisfy requirements of law functions. Now, these are the functions of accounting. First, record keeping function. Second, managerial function. Third, legal requirement function. And fourth, language of business. Now, following are the advantages of accounting. It helps in having complete record of business transactions. Second, it gives information about the profit and loss made by the business at close of a year and its financial condition. It provides useful information for making economic decisions. Third, it facilitates comparative study of current year profit, sales, expense, etc. with those of the previous years. Fourth, it supplies information useful in judging the management ability to utilize enterprise resources effectively in achieving primary enterprise goal. Fifth, it helps in complying with certain legal formalities like filing of income tax, sale tax returns. If accounts are properly maintained, the assessment of taxes is greatly facilitated. Now, following are the limitations of accounting. First, accounting is historical in nature. It does not reflect the current financial position worth of business. Second, transaction of non-monetary nature does not find place in accounting. Accounting is limited to monetary transactions only. Third, facts recorded in financial statements are greatly influenced by accounting conventions and personal judgments of the accountant or management. Fourth, accounting principles are not static or unchanging. Alternative accounting procedures are often equally acceptable. Therefore, accounting statements do not always present comparable data. Fifth, accounting statement does not show the impact of inflation. Sixth, accounting statements does not reflect those increase in net assets value that are not considered realized. Methods of accounting. Business transactions are recorded in two different ways. Those are, first, single entry, second, double entry. Single entry, it is incomplete system of recording business transactions. The business organizations maintains only cash book and personal account of debtors and creditors. So, the complete recording of transactions cannot be made and trial balance cannot be prepared. Second one is double entry. In this system, every business transaction is having twofold effect of benefits giving and benefit receiving aspect. The recording is made on the basis of both these aspects. Double entry is an accounting system that records the effects of transactions and other events in at least two accounts with equal debits and credits. Now, next is types of accounts. Accounts are of two types, personal accounts and impersonal accounts. We'll discuss in detail first personal accounts. Account recording transaction with a person or group of person are known as personal accounts. These accounts are necessarily in particular to record credit transactions. Personal accounts are of following types. First, natural person, as account recording transactions with an individual human being is termed as a natural persons. Natural accounts, examples, Kamal's accounts, Mala's account, Sharma's account, both males and females are included in it. Second is artificial or legal person. An account recording financial transaction with an artificial person credited by law or otherwise in terms as an artificial person. Personal account. Example, firm's account, limited companies accounts, educational institution accounts, cooperative society accounts. Third is group representative personal account. An account indirectly representing a person or persons is known as representative personal account. When accounts are of similar nature and their number is large, it's better to group them under one head and open a representative personal account. Example, prepaid insurance, outstanding salaries, rent, wages, etc. The rule of personal account is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Next is impersonal accounts. These accounts include the following types. Real accounts. Accounts relating to properties or assets are known as real accounts. A separate account is maintained for each asset. Example, cash machinery, building, etc. Real accounts can be further classified into tangible and intangible. Tangible real accounts. These accounts represent assets, properties which can be seen, touched, felt, measured, purchased and sold. Example, machinery account, cash account, furniture account and stock account, etc. Second is intangible real account. These accounts represents assets, properties which cannot be seen, touched or felt, but they can be measured in terms of money. Example, goodwill account, patents account, trademark account, copyright account, etc. The rule for real account is debit comes in, credits what goes out. Next is nominal accounts. Accounts relating to income, revenue, gain, expenses and losses are termed as nominal accounts. These accounts are also known as fictitious account, as they do not represent any tangible asset. A separate account is maintained for each head or expense or loss and gain or income, wages account, rent account, commission account, interest receive account are some example of nominal account. The rule for nominal accounts is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. These are the difference between bookkeeping and accounting as shown in the screen. Now next is the branches of accounting. The changing business scenario over the centuries give rise to specialized branches of accounting which could cater to changing requirements. The branches of accounting are basically three: financial accounting, second cost accounting, and third management accounting. Now moving to our next module, which is module 2, ledger. A ledger is a group of account. Most of us have probably seen a bound book with a word ledger printed on the cover. All the account of a small business industry could be entered into a ledger. In concern accounts in a summarized and classified form. From a journal, a trader cannot know his total cash, purchase, amount spent under each head of expense, and amount earned under each head of income. The journal will not tell him what he owes to his creditors and what his customer owe to him. Such classified information can be got only by opening a ledger accounts for every kind of transaction. Every ledger has two sides, namely a debit and credit. Left hand side is debit and right hand side is credit. Each side of ledger has columns on date, particular, journal folio and amount. Now moving to ledger posting. Transferring the entries from a journal or a subsidiary book to a ledger is known as posting. Posting the ledger from journal is easy as the transaction in the journal are already classified into debit and credit. However, the following points must be noted while posting a ledger. For the same person or expense, only one account should be opened. Cash and credit sales should be posted to sales account and cash and credit purchase to purchase account. The word debit as DR and credit as CR should not be omitted. Next is date and folio column should not be left blank. Balancing of ledger. At periodic interval, the debit and credit side of individual ledger accounts are totaled and balance of each account is indicated. If the total of the debit side of any account is more than the credit side, there will be a debit balance. And same, if the credit side is more than the debit side, there will be a credit balance. Example of ledger is shown. Module 3, journal entry. Journal entry is the record of accounting information for a business transaction. The entry is made in a journal. The journal entry has a date accounts debited and accounts credited. In journal entry, the total debits must be equal to total credits. What is the need of journal? First, convenient recording of a transaction. Second, maintaining and preserving the identity of transaction. Third, ascertaining the true nature of transaction with the help of narrations. Fourth, maintaining permanent record of information. Now, what are the steps of journalizing? First, ascertain what accounts are involved in transaction. Second, ascertain what the nature of accounts involved is. Third, ascertain which rule of debit and credit is applicable for each of the accounts involved. Fourth, ascertain which account is to be debited and which to be credited. Fifth, record the date of transaction in the date column. Now moving to the characteristics of journal. Journal is a book of original entry because transaction recorded at first stage in this book. Journal is the first step in recording process of double entry system of bookkeeping. In journal, transactions are recorded in it on day-to-day basis and when they are take place. Next is, journal is chronological record of all transactions taking place according to the order of occurrence. Every entry in journal accompanied with narration which describe briefly the true nature and context of transaction. Amount of the transaction is recorded in both debit and credit column side by side. Format of journal entry is shown on the screen. Before moving to our next module about the trial balance, I would like to suggest you to visit our website www.cec.nic.in for further reading and learning of more topic associated with your B.Pharm syllabus. Here you will find many lectures, e-contents, FAQs, LORs and many more. Hope this site will be as a catalyst of learning for you. Now moving to next module, module 4, the trial balance. The trial balance may be defined as a statement which contains balances of all ledger accounts on a particular date. Trial balance consists of a debit column with all the debit balances of the accounts and credit column with all the credit balances of the account. The total of these columns, if tally, it is presumed that the ledger has been maintained correctly. However, the trial balance provides only the arithmetical accuracy of posting in the ledger. Objectives of preparing a trial balance. Following are the objectives of preparing trial balance. First, to check arithmetical accuracy. Second, to help in preparing financial statements. Third, help in locating errors. Fourth, helps in comparison. Fifth, helps in making adjustment. Example is shown on the screen. Now moving to steps to prepare trial balance. At first, ascertain the balance account wishes of all the ledger accounts. Second, write the name of the ledger account in the ledger account column. Third, write against the name of the ledger account the balance amount, total amount, debit balance, total in the debit column, and credit balance, total in the credit column. Fourth, add the debit balance, total amount column, and credit balance, total amount column. There are three methods of preparing trial balance. First is balance method, second is total method, and third is balance totals method. Now we'll describe first balance method. In this balance method, the balance of each account, which may be debit balance or credit balance, is extracted and written against each account. We write debit balance in the debit column and credit balance in the credit column. Second, total method. In this method, the total of both sides of every account in the ledger is written against the name of the respective account without balancing them in the form of debit and credit balance respectively. Now, the third one, balance total method. Trial balance is prepared by combining the first and the second method. However, in practice, the trial balance is prepared with debit and credit balance of various accounts in the ledger. Normally, balance method is used. Moving to last module, module 5, that is cash book. Cash book records all transactions related to receipts and payments in terms of cash only. Types: cash books may be of the following types. First, simple cash book. Second, bank column cash book. Third, petty cash book. Description of first, simple cash book. A simple cash book records only cash receipts and cash payments. It has two sides, namely debit and credit. Cash receipts are recorded on the debit side, that means left side, and cash payments are recorded on the credit side, that means right side. In this book, there is only one amount column on its debit side and on the credit side. The format of simple cash book is as shown in the figure. Column-wise explanation is as follows. Date. In this column, year, month and date of transactions are recorded in chronological order. Second, particulars. In this column, name of the account in respect of which the cash has been received or payment has been made is written. Account pertaining to the receipt of cash recorded on the debit side and those pertaining to cash payments on the credit side. Third, ledger folio. In this column, it records the page number of the ledger book on which relevant account is prepared. Fourth, amount. In this column, it records the amount received on debit side and cash paid on the credit side. Preparation of simple cash book. Cash book is in a way a cash account with debit and credit side, and cash account is an asset account. So the rule followed is increase in the asset to be debited and decrease in the asset to be credited. This implies that cash book is a book where all the receipts in the term of cash are recorded on the debit side of the cash book and all the payments in the terms of cash are recorded on the credit side. This means on the debit side, in the particular column, the name of the account for which cash is received is recorded. Similarly, on the credit side, the name of the account for which cash is paid is recorded. In the amount column, the actual cash paid or received is recorded. At the end of the month, cash book is balanced. The cash book is balanced in the same manner as account is balanced. In the ledger, the total of the debit side of the cash book is compared with the total of the credit side of the different in any entered or credit side of the cash book. Under the particular column as balance credit. In case of simple cash book, if total of the debit side is always more than the total of the credit side, since the payment can never be exceeded the available cash. The difference is written in the amount column and total of the both side of the cash book becomes equal. The closing balance of the credit side becomes the opening balance of the next period and is written as the balance on the debit side of the cash book for of the following period. Next is bank column cash book. When the number of bank transactions is large in an organization, it is necessary to have a separate book record bank transactions. Instead of having a separate book to record bank transaction, a column is added on each side of the simple cash book. This type of cash book is known as bank column cash book. All the payments in bank are recorded on the debit side. All withdrawals payments through the bank are recorded on the credit side of the cash book. The format of bank column cash book is shown on the screen. Last is petty cash book. In big business organization, a large number of repetitive small payments such as for conveyance, cartridge, postage, telegrams, courier and other expenses are made. These organizations appoint an assistant to the head cashier. The appointed cashier is known as petty cashier. He makes payments of these expenses and maintains a separate cash book record these transactions. Such a cash book is called petty cash book. Next is bank reconciliation statement. bank reconciliation statement is a statement prepared to reconcile the difference between bank balance as per the bank column of cash book and pass book on any given date. Strictly speaking, there should be a difference between balance shown by the pass book and the cash book. This is so if all the entries recorded in both. Now, need and importance of bank reconciliation statement. The need and importance of bank reconciliation statement may be given as follows. The reconciliation process helps in bringing out the errors committed either in cash book or pass book. Second, bank reconciliation statement may also show any undue delay in clearance of check. Third, sometimes the cashier have the tendency of cheating, like he may made entries in the cash book only but never deposit the cash into the bank. These type of frauds by the entrepreneur, a staff or bank staff may be detected only through the bank reconciliation statement. So this way, bank reconciliation statement act as a control technique too. The reason for difference in the balance of the cash book and the petty cash book are as under. Checks issued by the firm but not yet presented or payment. Second, check deposit into the bank but not yet collected. Third, amount directly deposited into the bank account. Fourth, bank charges. Fifth, interest and dividend received by the bank. Sixth, direct payment made by the bank on behalf of the customer. Seventh, dishonor of the check, bill discounted. 8th, error committed in the recording transaction by the firm. 9th, errors committed in the recording transaction by the bank. Different situations for preparing the bank reconciliation statement. These are favorable balances. Debit balances as per cash book is given as the balance as per pass book is to be ascertained. Second, credit balance as per pass book given and the balance as per cash book is to be ascertained unfavorable balance or draft balance. First, credit balance as per cash book is given as the balances per pass book to be ascertained. B, debit balance as per pass book is given and the balance as per cash book is to be ascertained. Now, moving to summary of this topic. Accounting plays a very vital role in the field of commerce and business. For maintaining the business record of any business, one should know the basic purpose of accounting, its merit, kinds of accounting, rules of accounting. These lectures cover up the very basic principles, objectives, advantages, limitations of accounting and basics like debit, credit, ledger posting, journal entry, trial balance, cash book and last the bank reconciliation statement. So thank you friends and hope to see you in the next episode. Bye bye.